Using a pivot table calculated field is the key to using formulas within pivot tables in Excel. In that way, you can create a spreadsheet such as this. So you, in this spreadsheet, you can see we've got the profit here. There we go. And we've got the percentage of the profit as well. So I'm Simon, a real life Excel trainer, and this Excel account tutorial will show you how to use formulas within your pivot tables. Let's get going. Okay, so if you've been following along with this series of Excel accounts tutorials, this I think is the 8th one, and so we have created, in the last couple, we've created a pivot table and done a financial year. This time we will need to work out the profit, because at the moment we can just see some of the received. So if you haven't been following along, you just come straight to this tutorial, then don't worry, I'll give you a link down below, and that'll give you a link to the supporting webpage where you can download the starter file, the completed file as well, and you'll also find step-by-step instructions there, so if you prefer to use that. So let's do that, this, shall we? So we're going to drag across this nicely created financial year slice. So that's what we did last time. I'm going to click on this pivot table. The first thing I need to do is add the expenses. So I'm going to go and just, let's have a look here. There we go. Just find expenses. I'm going to drag expenses down and just drop it underneath sum of received in values. And now I can see my expenses that have been added here to the pivot table. So now it is in the wrong format, so I need to change the format of this in the pivot table to pounds and pence. So right click on the actual field, sum of expenses, and go to number format. And I like accounting, so I'm just going to double click on accounting so that it's formatted as in a currency format. Just drag financial year to the right. I'm going to click here. And as I said before, the key to this is using a pivot table calculated field. That's how you would write formulas within a pivot table. What do I mean by that? Well, if you look at the top of your ribbon in Excel, you'll find at the top of the screen, you'll find the pivot table analyze tab. So give that a click. And then there's a drop down menu to the right, if I get that right, there we go, called fields, items, and sets. And we're going to click on calculated field. And in this calculated field box, we can type in the formula for the calculated field. First thing we need to do is give it a name. It's highlighted in gray, so it's ready to start typing. And this calculated field is going to be called profit. So I'm going to now get rid of the zero in the formula, leave the equal sign in there. And so the formula is going to be received. So I double click on received here. Press plus on the keyboard. Oops, click back at the top here. Press plus on the keyboard and then expense. And the reason I'm going receive plus expense is because the expense are negative numbers. So once that's done, I click on OK. And now I can see my sum of the profit. It's automatically picked up the currency format, or rather, I should say the accounting format in the pivot table. But if you want to change, you can right click and change the format. Great, looking good. But let's go into more detail with this pivot table calculated field by working out a percentage. So we're going to use this sum of profit as a basis to work out how much is that as a percentage of the sum of received. So we can have a quick look to see when we made a good amount of profit as a percentage. So let me just drag financial year to the right. We'll make sure we've got our pivot table selected. Make sure we've clicked on pivot table analyze that you can see at the top. Click on fields, items, and sets and go down to calculated field. Let me just get in close. So this, I'm going to call this one profit percentage. And the formula in this is going to be the profit divided by the received. So how much profit divided by the received? I'm going to click on OK. And yeah, it's looking good. It's just formatted incorrectly. It's formatted as accounting or currency. We want it formatted as percentage. So right click anywhere in the sum of profit column, go to number format, double click on percentage. So there you go. Now you know how to use formulas within pivot tables. And the key is using the pivot table calculated field facility. Now, if you've got anything out of this tutorial, give us a thumbs up. It will really be appreciated. Thank you very much. Of course, if you're on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, then please reach out to me there. It'd be great to hear from you. If you have any comments or any suggestions on how you use calculated fields within pivot tables, then put them in the comment section below. Now, the next thing we're going to look at is, of course, we've got the sum of profits, as we can see just here. But say, for instance, we want to have a minimum profit of 90%. And when that occurs, then we get the entire row highlighted in red. That's right. We're going to have a look at conditional formatting within a pivot table, how to do that. So make sure you subscribe and make sure that you click on the notifications button so you don't miss a thing. Hope everyone's keeping well, and I hope everyone's okay. I just really want to say thank you so much for watching.